نحمد و نصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي صدق الله العظيم Dr. Arif Alvi, President of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, Sayyid Murad Ali Shah, Chief Minister Sindh, Ms. Zubaida Jalal, Minister for Defense Production, Professor Dr. Ismail Demir, President of the Turkish Defense Industry, Mr. Mohsin Deir, Deputy Minister of Turkish National Defense, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests, Ladies and Gentlemen, and Ship's Company of PNS Marvin. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah's peace, blessing and mercy be on all of us. It is my profound privilege to welcome you all on this historic occasion of the commissioning of the largest warship ever built in Pakistan in collaboration with our Turkish brothers. At the outset, I would like to profoundly thank the President of Pakistan for sparing his valuable time and honoring us with his presence. It is also our pleasure to have Professor Dr. Ismail Demir, President of the Turkish Defense Industry, and Mr. Mohsin Deir, Deputy Minister of National Defense Turkey, to have flown all the way from Turkey to be part of today's proceedings. The combat support ship PNS Marvin is the second ship carrying this name. It is a symbol of pride and a landmark achievement. It reflects the strength of our industrial base and the remarkable acumen and commitment of our engineers, technicians, and dedicated workers. Induction of this ship will indeed be a valuable addition to Pakistan Naval fleet and shall go a long way in supporting sustained fleet operations at sea. The ship is also equipped with modern medical facilities to support PN fleet and to undertake humanitarian assistance and disaster relief operations both at home and abroad. Construction of PNS Marvin at Karachi Shipyard in collaboration with MESS STM of Turkey under the ambit of Ministry of Defense Production and Pakistan Navy is a true testament of our resolve towards indigenization and enhancing collaboration with our Turkish brothers. I congratulate Ministry of Defense Production, Karachi Shipyard and MESS STM of Turkey for successfully undertaking this huge mission. It is a matter of great satisfaction that this cooperation will continue in future as more warships will be built at Karachi Shipyard in collaboration with Turkish government and companies. In this regard, the recent signing of the contract for the construction of 4 Milgem class corvettes will further strengthen the existing cooperation and enhance the strategic partnership between our two countries. Pakistan has enormous maritime potential which needs to be exploited to boost our economy. There are extensive trade and maritime activities being undertaken at our two major seaports of Karachi and Port Qasim. The trade activities are poised to increase many folds with the growth in transit and transshipment trade, especially with the culmination of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and operationalization of Gwadar Port. We therefore need to create additional capacity to support expansion in these activities. Multiple shipyards to meet the construction and repair requirements of the exponential increase the number of commercial ships operating off our coast would be a prerequisite to achieve this objective. Pakistan is strategically located at the mouth of the Gulf from where the energy flows to all parts of the globe. We owe our progress and prosperity to the sea from where almost 95% of our trade flows. This requires a safe and secure maritime environment for which an efficient, strong, versatile and potent Navy is indispensable. It cannot be overemphasized that surface ships, owing to their inherent resilience, reach and capacity for prolonged operations at sea, remain the most feasible platform in dealing with today's maritime challenges. Acquisition of surface ships is therefore high on our priority for continuous monitoring and policing of our area of responsibility. The commissioning of PNS Marvin is a consolidation of our capability and commitment to safeguard the maritime frontiers by investing in modern platforms built by our own shipbuilding industry. I am pleased to inform that Pakistan Navy in the recent years has been striving for achieving self-reliance in warship construction. Construction of various naval platforms like missile craft, F-22P frigate, submarines and combat support ships in the past, and various warships and submarine construction projects planned in the future will inshallah enhance our shipping capabilities. Pakistan follows a policy of peaceful coexistence and has no aggressive designs against any other country. However, our desire for peace should not be taken as our weakness. Pakistan Navy and indeed the Pakistan Armed Forces, with the support of the Pakistani nation, remain fully ready and committed to thwart any aggression against our country.